I was born in Craiova, but I stayed there just for a few days. I know that my mother, when she was talking about her horrible marriage and my horrible father, she was a very romantic 16-year-old. And when she had a better look at him and married him, she couldn't stand it and she divorced immediately. I think she even didn't know that she was expecting a baby. And there I was. We had a very unconventional family. My aunt mom would stay in bed until 2. Her husband was coming, hoping to have lunch. She hadn't ordered the lunch yet. My famous Uncle Joe, who educated me, and he's the one who brought me all the art books. And he was very interested in my talent. He pushed me a lot.
I think Noche exemplifies the value of non-institutionalized education. She is totally self-taught, and what it's done for her is opened up her creativity to the point where it's been unbridled. Noche's work is very sensual. That's, to me, the key element, is pure sensuality. Sensuousness has more to do with the appetite for life, the experience of life through the senses. And she is truly somebody who has learned to use each one of her senses to the fullest.
We live at a certain moment in a house was just ideal for a child, a lonely child with lots of imagination, because it was a house with several floors and that had been sort of abandoned. So I had a wonderful time doing all my creative work, and I amused myself. The mad Angèle. Angèle was Swiss, and she was madly religious. She was beating me every day, saying it's her duty to punish me for my future sin. So all those witches and animals and all that were the bad part of what had happened. I was invited for an Easter holiday, and I stayed 5 years because I loved it there. And she, Martine, like me, had been a very lonesome child. Her family had been very wealthy and of a very high society. And then during the war, they had 3 daughters of marrying age. So they were giving parties for the German, all that. Everybody considered them like traitors and turned their back on them. My life was absolutely taken by their life. I had totally abandoned my family, but I had a better time at Black Lake, and I would write, and, well, I will come in 1 week and all that. So my mother and Mumuts didn't like me to be away, but I always did what I wanted. Romania is a country of earthquakes. We had many earthquakes in Romania. My house in the country was totally destroyed by an earthquake. And you know, I liked parties so much that we put the house together and build it again. And I gave a party commemorating the earthquakes. You know, sometimes it doesn't have to have a sense. I like the shape of the snakes. I like also the fact that they are a symbol of sin, and I have very much sympathy for sin. You know, Lilith was the first wife of Adam, and it didn't work. She wanted to be the equal, and they didn't click at all. So she left Adam, and she married Lucifer. And they went along very well. They are still married. They couldn't have real children. They had little demons, and the succubi were the demon. I like the woman figure, you know, that's the image of woman I like. The woman in the boudoir, not the woman with a typewriter. But I think the breast is the most sculptural form. And I never painted flat women. I think that the most feminine rooms, that's where the women are. I am very interested in bordellos, and I have some wonderful photograph of bordellos and prostitutes and the madam and all that. And also Sanctuary by Faulkner inspired me very much. I think they are decorative, and I like the way they look, but also they capture the viewer. He looks at the mirror look at him back, and I think it captures people, it puts them in the temporary prison of the mirror. And sometimes you do something with just you like the look of it, and then you have to find reason and pretext, because people ask why. I don't ask why. I like it and I do it.
I think a lot of Noche's demons in her paintings are ones that she doesn't wrestle with so much as plays with. They are all of the negative things that are an integral part of each human being, and yet they are expressed as a vital, important part, not to be hidden, not to be swept under the rug, but to be celebrated.